significant new rare earth element deposit in Jamaica. This is according to the Investor News, and this is an express by geophysics. Now, if you are not aware, rare earth elements is like the new big thing in the mining space. The global industries that's pushing the whole attraction and demand for rare earth elements include the electrical vehicles, renewable industries or renewable resources, and obviously our mobile devices, electronic devices. Now, as per the Investor News article, geophysics, through its geochemical exploratory work, has identified this rare earth element in a total area of approximately 100 kilometers square. What it is that they went on to say is that they would have done borehole drill testing, and they would have dug as deep as the basement of limestone rocks in some areas. What they found is an extensive near-surface era of rare earth mineralization, and this is predominantly in bauxite. The document went on to say that total rare earth oxide grades in the region of 1500 parts per million, and the approximate weight of this total rare earth is that of 40%. Scandium grades of 40 to 50 parts per million were found. Thorium and uranium were found in the region of 15 parts per million. I want to take this moment just to pause on these points here. Thorium, uranium, radioactive elements. If you are aware about the whole nuclear talk, whether it be from nuclear power plants to nuclear arms, these elements are mentioned in those discussions. And for it to now be a case that here we are talking about Jamaica also bearing these elements, albeit in small quantities, is still a significant reality or revelation. So kudos goes to geophysics on their work. What this basically points to is the need for additional research towards further analyzing in depth Jamaica's soils and rocks for these elements. Now, at this point, you should gather that for bauxite, whilst it being a primary source for aluminium, is also a source for rare earth elements. And on that basis, our mud lakes is also a good source of these elements. The research I came across highlights some articles as far back as 2013, Jamaica Information Service articles, whereby government ministers at the time would have been having some form of public discourse or expression that rare earth elements are basically found in Jamaica's red mud or in Jamaica's bauxite lakes. So with that being said, the bauxite as a sedimentary deposit is known for its rare earth elements. However, the source of rare earth elements comes from within the earth. And in so doing, if it's a case that Jamaica has sedimentary deposits, it is likely that basically the source comes from igneous rocks. And this is now where the research from Tashane Booth, among other researchers, would have highlighted that the Newcastle porphyry in eastern Jamaica, which is their research or study area, gives good indication or is a primary source of medium to heavy rare earth elements. Basically, the Newcastle porphyry is that of an adakite. And in that respect, basically, adakites are known as that source of igneous rock, if you will, that basically is also a good source of rare earth elements. So with that being said, it is basically a case that we can more than likely infer that through weathering and erosion, of igneous source rocks, such as the Newcastle porphyry and other rocks that are of similar geochemistry within different regions of Jamaica, that this form of weathering erosion forms the basis whereby bauxite deposits end up being concentrated sources of rare earth elements.